the cleanup project at Santa Susana Field Laboratory Center in Simi Valley, Southern California. During its years of operation, widespread use occurred of highly toxic chemical additives to power over 30,000 rocket engine tests and to clean the rocket test stands afterwards, as well as considerable nuclear research and at least 4 nuclear accidents, which has resulted in the SSFL becoming a seriously contaminated site and off-site pollution source, requiring a sophisticated multi-agency and corporate cleanup project. A long process has been and is still ongoing to determine the site contamination levels and locations, cleanup standards to be met, methods to use, timelines and costs, and completion requirements, all still being defined, debated, and litigated. The Santa Susana Field Lab Cleanup Project is a very complex challenge technically, logistically, politically, legally, and emotionally. And they don't care. Regarding cleanup, the site's current owner is Boeing, with NASA and DOE liable for several parcels within that. On August 2, 2005, Pratt & Whitney purchased Boeing's Rocketdyne division, but declined to acquire SSFL as part of the sale. The standards history. In 1989, the DOE found widespread chemical and radioactive contamination at their site, and a cleanup program commenced. In 1995, the EPA and DOE announced that they had entered into a joint policy agreement to assure that all DOE sites would be cleaned up to standards consistent with the EPA's Comprehensive Environmental Response, Compensation, and Liability Act standards, called CERCLA. However, in March 2003, the DOE reversed its position and announced that SSFL would not be cleaned up to EPA standards. In other words, no, we don't care. While the DOE simultaneously claimed compliance with the 1995 Joint Policy Agreement, the new plan included a cleanup of only 1% of the contaminated soil and the release of SSFL for unrestricted residential use in as little as 10 years. So they wanted to barely clean up 1% of all the contaminated soil so that they could turn around and sell it off, because they already had buyers to start with more residential building. The EPA responded to this announcement by claiming that the DOE was not subject to EPA regulation due to the fact that the DOE existed as a separate entity under the executive branch of the federal government and refused to take steps to force DOE adherence to the 1995 agreement. So here we go again. Here we go again. Anything that has to do with the government, they'll fight it. No, they'll walk away, as they do with everything else that they taint with their poisonous workings. In August 2003, the Senate Appropriations Committee issued a report on energy and water appropriations, urging the DOE to meet its commitments in the 1995 agreement and clean up Santa Susana to the EPA CERCLA standards. The DOE responded to the Senate, claiming it was in fact consistent with both the agreement and EPA CERCLA standards. In December 2003, soon after DOE's announcement that it was consistent with the agreement, the EPA determined that the cleanup was not consistent with CERCLA standards, and that sufficient contamination will remain at levels that would be dangerously inappropriate for unrestricted residential, and that the only safe use under DOE's revised cleanup standards would be restricted to day hikes with limitations on picnicking. Again, they don't give a shit. Critics point out that if the DOE Boeing cleanup plan was followed through and the site was released for unrestricted residential use, the property would likely become a Superfund site subject to EPA standards, which would then again push this out another 30 or 40 years, and they drag their feet. They have no urgency at all on any of these Superfund sites. After the sale, the site would no longer be a DOE facility, and thus the exemption from CERCLA standards would no longer be in effect. The end result being that the site would only be brought into compliance with CERCLA cleanup standards after Boeing has sold the property, relieving the company of any burden of cleanup costs. The costs would likely be passed on to the taxpayers, of course, and not those responsible for the actual contamination. Of course, this is what they do. This is business as usual. You poison us, and not only do we pay with our lives, we pay out of our pockets. In early 2007, a federal court in San Francisco issued a major ruling which concluded that DOE has not been cleaning up the site to proper standards, and that the site would have to be cleaned up to higher standards if DOE ever wanted to release the site to Boeing, which in turn would most likely release the land for unrestricted residential development. Judge Conte's ruling requires DOE to prepare a more stringent review of the lab, which is on the border of the Los Angeles County. Conte wrote that the department's decision to prepare a less stringent environmental document prior to cleanup is in violation of the National Environmental Policy Act, and noted that the lab is located only miles away from one of the largest population centers in the world. I don't know, why doesn't anybody go to jail over this? If you owned a construction company and you built something and you contaminated the land and the environment, you would go to jail for not cleaning it up. But no, not the DOE, not Boeing, not any of these people. Why? Because they're all linked to the fucking government, who doesn't give a shit. On July 26, 2007, staff at the Los Angeles Regional Water Quality Control Board recommended a $471,000 fine against Boeing for 79 violations of the California Water Code during a little over a year. 79 violations in 18 months. From October 2004 to January 2006, wastewater and storm water runoff coming from the lab had increased levels of chromium, dioxin, lead, mercury, and other pollutants. The contaminated water flowed into Bell Creek and the Los Angeles River in violation of a July 1, 2004 permit that allowed release of wastewater and storm runoff as long as it didn't contain high levels of pollutants. Boeing's explanation? It's all coming from natural radioactivity, not us. However, huge amounts of radioactivity were tested and proven. And they didn't like this. I mean, they had tritium off the charts, and they didn't like this, so they decided they were going to go and get somebody else to, from their company, to do their own tests. Strontium 90 recently found. found again. That was in 2006. So, oh boy, these people are just something else. And, you know, this is business as usual in every country on the planet. Every country on the planet. If they can get away with it, they will. And they got away with this for a lot of years. A lot of years. Now, when their comeuppance is due, they're just straight up saying they're not going to do it. They're not even going to do 1% of a cleanup. Action taken? None. Water Board has issued no notices of the violation for the strontium. None. Just other pollutants. And this is an article from the Radioactive Contamination of Water at the Santa Susana Field Laboratory by Daniel Hirsch, Committee to Bridge the Gap, in him, the community meeting of April 2006. Okay, sorry for the rant, but this is just absurd. Absolutely absurd. Where's all these multi-million dollar movie stars? Why aren't they doing something? They're the only ones with the money that can do anything. Why don't they use their voices? Because you know what? Our voices are not heard. As always, God bless.